on a grassy hill, a multitude was sitting still, listening to what Jesus had to say. Well, he was teaching and healing folks, and what I'm telling you ain't no joke. We got hungry cause we hadn't had a bite all day. Well, the crowd was getting kind of rambunctious. See, none of them had brought their lunch except one little boy whose mama had packed him one. Just two little fish and five loaves of bread was in his basket, but he said we could have them since everyone else had none. Well, I suggested we send them down to catch a bite at the nearest town. It was the thing to do. I was so sure. You see, it had been plumb hot all day, and it wasn't long you could hear me say, "Them fish, Lord, they ain't smelling none too kosher." When Jesus fed the multitude, Jesus said to sit them down in groups of 50 on the ground, said, "Just stand back, you'll see the hand of God." Well, at that time I didn't believe, but I had to see what was up his sleeve and how he would feed this motley squad. Well, he looked up to heaven and prayed a while, and it wasn't long before I smiled. Those loaves of bread looked like they'd just been baked. And unless my nose was playing tricks, then something happened to those fish. They smelled as if they'd just come out of the lake. Well, Jesus broke the bread and the meat, gave some to Tom, he gave some to Pete, and said, "Just believe and never doubt." Well, right there, things got kind of rowdy, walking amongst that hungry crowd. See, we had the food and the chore of giving it out. When Jesus fed the multitude, said, "Hey, Miss Goldstein, enjoy your trip. You got your choice between an eye and a lip. I don't think there's gonna be much. I hope you don't mind." Well, Mr. Steinberg had just walked up and said he'd try a tail and some crust. I said, "I'll go back and I'll see what I can find." But not long after that, I realized that everyone, to my surprise, was stuffed. No one could eat no more. Not only were they satisfied, but looking on the ground, I spied 12 large doggy bags to go. Well, the moral of the story is clear to all. Just ask in faith, whether great or small, and he'll give us more than we could ever claim. 'Cause from day-old fish and moldy bread, a multitude of folks were fed, a meal that would put Red Lobster plumb to shame. When Jesus fed multitude, when Jesus fed the multitude, and that's just the way it happened. Well, sorta.